Hi there, this is Baron with a let's play of Ultima Underworld 2. As you can see, there's a portcullis and it is locked, but we can open it. It is locked. Ah, it didn't work, see? It had no effect. This time it works. So let's see what we find here. Oh, careful. That is a tomb ruin. That would probably petrify us, you know, paralyze us. But you can, oh, someone throws arrows at us. Maybe we could prevent that by pulling the lever? No. I don't know what the lever does. Ouch. Yes, but if you see a rune like that, throw an item through it. Oh, the lever probably closed the portcullis. Throw an item through the rune, and you will trigger the rune with that. Maybe the item will get destroyed, and if you want to prevent that from happening, throw a coin through the rune, because coins can't be destroyed. Yes, so the portcullis is also locked, so let's open it. Why do my open spells not... Why do they not... Why do... Don't they work? Okay. And we have a hostile mongbat. Oh, is that nice. Okay. And I guess the lever here would close the portcullis again. Yeah, see, it's closed. But we can open it. And there's another mongbat. So yeah. But I think the... You know, the puzzle that you had to solve is, you know, the plate in the room behind us where we dropped the golden thingy on it. The coffer. I think that was here. What is it? A coffer, yeah. That was the puzzle. Because Alcor don't do that to me. Another opponent somewhere. Another bat. They seem to be respawning here. And now he tried... Oh, it was damaged. Again. They seem to be respawning somewhere. Oh, wait a second. Do we get experience for killing those? We have 1,902 experience points. And now we have 1,917. Oh, we get experience points. Great. Okay. It's still an excellent broadsword. So let's get the hell out of Dodge. Okay, we mapped out the whole area. It looks a little bit like a person, I think, you know, with the head and the two arms above the head. Okay, yes. Put a cover on the plate, and that opens the portcullis that leads to the exit. And we are in the next part. See? Section 2, Equilibrium and Non-Local Causality. And if we would walk into that, we would be teleported back to the first section. Jump over that. And... ice. I hate ice. Did I mention that I hate ice? No, I don't wanna... glide into the water. Shit. See, there's a current. We can't swim in the other direction. Or can you? Yeah, but very slowly. Okay. So let's move on. No, this is the right direction. We have to swim into that direction. What is he doing with us? Oh. Okay. Yeah, that is a problem with the ice level here. You have to move very slowly to keep in control. So that's what we're going to do now. Go away. Move it. Okay, so at least we mapped out a watery area. Nice. Yeah, slowly but steady. Don't blame me. Yeah, there's nothing here, okay. Oh, we hurt a little, but doesn't matter. Not much. What do we have here? Some solid ground. That's nothing. Yeah, our button. Let's press it. And there are some things lying on the ground. A broadsword. Serviceable. It's not magical, so we don't need it. Drop it. A wand. That would... I don't want a shield. Go away. Obviously, somebody bought a farm here. A wand with paralyze with two full charges in it. I don't know. And a potion. A magical brown potion. We could cast an identification spell now, but since mana does not regenerate on this level, we are not going to waste our mana here. We will identify the potion later. And I don't know, a wand of paralyze. Who are we supposed to paralyze here? There's nobody here. I mean, the only other guy here is, you know, downstairs waiting for 63 years. 63 years. Well, he probably has a higher life expectancy than a normal human being. See? There was a portcullis, and by you could still see the portcullis. By pushing the button, we opened it. So we still have to explore that part here. Yes, I want my maps mapped out nicely. Excuse me, I don't wanna glide. I don't wanna glide. No, don't fall into the water! Ah! Okay. We managed, but barely. I hate ice. I could use some spikes on my plate boots. But no such luck. Can we? No, probably not. You know, we'd still have to explore that part, but I don't think there's anything of interest in here, so let's head into that direction. There's probably more ice on the other side. Oh, damn, I was afraid of that. See, now we're gliding. We're back where we started. Okay, let's try something else. Now we move into that direction. And jump. You know, okay, that worked. Just before you glide into a wall, try to jump. This is the only way to regain control. So, okay. No, I want it in the other direction. Okay. What do we find here? Nothing. Jump. Yeah, okay. This sucks. Okay. More to explore. Wait a second. Part 2. Ah, synchronization. Okay. So this is the second part of the maze. We should save here. that you have to get through that part here. Try not to get hit. Well, it doesn't matter. Those are just arrows, as long as they're not throwing fireballs at us. Oh, see, there's a wand on the next platform. Excuse me, let me take the bloody wand. What does it do? I don't know. And there's the exit. Yeah, but we can't reach it now. Exit! Great. So, we're going to take a break here and we will continue in the next video. So, thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye!